chicken tandoori with a splash of bhangra. After this, we had West Bengal, where we had Rabindra Sangeet with Rosgulla. And this year, we are back with Maharashtra. I think if you are going with the same pace, it will take 29 years to finish all the states of India. Don't you think?
Yeah, but that's too long.
What to do?
We can go on monthly basis.
I don't think
that's true too. So let's continue. So if you see the map of India, Maharashtra is situated on the left side of the west coast along the Indian Sea, and Maharashtra is the third largest state of India. How big is it? Let's compare it to Germany. So if you see Germany and Maharashtra, both of them have similar land area.
I don't think so.
Okay. Flip the Germany map. Okay, put it over Maharashtra. Yeah, now you see.
Now I get it. How many people live over there?
Around 114 million, slightly more than Germany.
Wow, that's a lot. Maybe that's why we are the richest state in the India.
Yeah. So let's see what language do we speak. Our language is called Marathi. And our script is Devanagari, and the letters look like this. It is similar to Sanskrit and Hindi. And like English has A, E, I, O, U as vowels, we have A, R, E, E, U, U, A, I, O, O, M, R. Yeah, 16 vowels. Our language is phonetic space, and when you combine a consonant with a vowel, then you have a letter.
Can you teach them some of the words?
Why not? So we'll see some slangs of Maharashtra. We'll start with Kasakai. So when you greet each other, you ask Kasakai. So it is just like we get it in Germany. And then you have
Baba.
So when you see your friend, you go like Baba. Wow. Why don't you try?
Baba!
Then the next one we have is Kadak. So Kadak is the word you use when you find something magnificent, like the last goal of Messi in the Champions League match. So the goal was Kadak. Then you have Ek Number. So Ek Number is something like
number one.
Very beautiful. Super. So when you try Indian food, you say
Ek Number.
And the last one you have today is Kandage. So when you want to say your friend to cool down, you go like Kandage.
That's an all about language. Let's see how this got developed. When I see history of Maharashtra, what do you guys think of?
Shivaji
Maharaj. But he was not only the one king. There were a lot of kings before him. There were Shalivans, Chalukyas, Rashtrakuts, and Shilahas. They built a lot of beautiful temples around Maharashtra. But tonight, we will start from Yadava dynasty. They were the first ones to use Marathi as an official language of the empire. And you see the fort over here? It's Devagiri Fort. It was the capital of the empire. But the Yadava dynasty ended with a raid by Alauddin Khilji in the 13th century, and the dark ages of Maharashtra began. Fortunately, this did not last that long. Within four centuries, sun rose up again, and we witnessed fall of Maratha Empire, our king, Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj. He was born in 16th century, and at the young age of 17, he established his self-rule and brought peace to Maharashtra. He was the first one to use guerrilla techniques against his foreign enemies and bring the peace in Maharashtra. You can see the guerrilla technique is still in use by modern armies around the world. And also, interestingly, he was the father of modern Indian Navy. The most interesting fact about Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj, he built a lot of forts around Maharashtra. Can you guys guess how many forts are there in Maharashtra? Just one second. Just take a wild guess. 47 is not even a close. There are around 350 forts in only Maharashtra.
After Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj, other notable warrior from Maharashtra was Bajirao Peshwa. During Bajirao Peshwa's reign, the Maratha Empire was expanded until the borders of Afghanistan, as you can see in this map. Marathas were the last one to resist Britishers in India, and after the fall of Maratha Empire, British had control all over the India. But even then, Maharashtrian people didn't give up. During our freedom fight, Lokmanya Tilak and Swatantravir Savarkar were two of the notable freedom fighters. In 1947, India got independence, and on 1st May 1960, modern state of Maharashtra was formed. So that's why we celebrate every 1st May as Maharashtra Din, and the recent one we had was on last Wednesday. We heard a lot about history of this great state. Do you want to know how the name came, Maharashtra? So, Maharashtra, Maha means great and Rashtra means nation. So let's hear more about the beauty of this great nation in a song. Actually, I always wanted to sing since I was a child. Can I join you guys?
Zari Patakya Sahabhagavya Jaitya Chaya Kachidesha Pranam Dhava Swaha Shri Maharashtra Desha. Pranam Gava Ma Swaha Shri Maharashtra Desha. Pranam Gava Ma Swaha Shri Maharashtra Desha.
Thank you, Shalini.
Kada, 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 kada,
that was 8 number performance. What do you guys think?
Yeah. 8 number, 8 number.
8 number.
Let's go on a short tour of Maharashtra. As you see in the map, Maharashtra lies along the sea. This coastal region over here is known as Konkan. It is beautiful. It is really, really beautiful. It is world famous for pristine beaches and natural beauty. And it is also famous for my favorite fruits, Alfonso mangoes and cashew nuts. Who doesn't like Alfonso mangoes?
After Konkan, we move up to the next region, which is known as Sahyadri Mountains. Sahyadri Mountains are parallel to the western coast, and those are very beautiful mountains, which is also a UNESCO biodiversity hotspot. In rainy season, we have so many waterfalls, so many magnificent waterfalls like this. And these mighty mountains are trekkers' heaven. Around 200 forts among 350 that we told you lie in this region. Ajinkya, how many of them you have visited?
Around 40.
40? That's a lot. I have visited only 15.
How many of you guys have visited these forts?
Nice.
Let's go on to the next biggest geographical region of Maharashtra. It is known as Deccan Plateau. It is world famous for the agricultural produce. You can see a lot of crops over here, grapes, sugarcane, onions. It also hosts a lot of major cities in Maharashtra. For example, Pune. Punekers in the house, make a noise. Wow, that's a lot. Pune is the cultural capital of Maharashtra, as it was seat of Maratha Empire for centuries. And modern day Pune is the hub of automobile and IT. But Pune is also famous for Punekers and their sarcastic comments. We can see some of them here. For example, first one over here. It says, after ringing the bell, please wait for 2 minutes. Superman doesn't live here. The second one says, you should not share your food with another at the restaurant, otherwise we will charge you extra. But don't worry guys, we won't charge you extra tonight. And the last one says, don't park in my driveway, otherwise I will puncture your tires. I think we all can relate to these signboards. And Deccan Plateau has hosted these beautiful caves, Ajanta and Ellora, which is UNESCO Heritage Site. As you see in this temple, this is Kailas Temple. It was monolithic structure built in only one rock, that too from upwards to bottom.
It was carved from upwards to bottom. After Deccan Plateau, we move to the other geographical region, Vidarbha. Vidarbha is a resource-rich region, and its main city in the region, Nagpur, is known as Tiger Capital of India. And it is also famous for its oranges. So if you go there, do try the oranges. Any Nagpur here? Yes. Woo! Woo!
Another player his last match in
Nagpur. And it is also home to. Yes, Lona Lake. Lona Lake is a one-of-a-kind of lake which was formed due to a meteorite impact 50,000 years ago. After that, we come to the last geographical region, the Satpura Ranges. In Satpura Ranges lie the city of Nasik, which is known as wine capital of India, and which is also famous for this tribal varli painting art. And it also hosts the largest religious gathering anywhere on the earth every 12 years, Kumbh Mela. Kumbh Mela is so big that it is also visible from space.
We are forgetting something over here. What do you guys think? Mumbai, obviously. It is formerly known as Bombay. It's the capital of Maharashtra and financial capital of the country. Do you guys know how the Bombay name came into existence? When the Portuguese first came to Bombay, they were amazed by the beautiful beach and they exclaimed, Bombay. It literally means in Portuguese, beautiful bay. Then that's why the name came into existence, Bombay. And the surprising fact about Bombay, this city, Bombay city, Portuguese gifted to British as a wedding gift of Charles II. I think they are regretting it now. Yeah, Bombay is also famous for the Bollywood. Bollywood is the world's second biggest cinema industry. And Bollywood movies are incomplete without melodious music. I think you will get to know after you listen to this song.
I don't have a mic for the guitar, so
it's too low.
So let me know. Is it too low?
Can you hear this?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. So this song is called Chansi Paris. If somebody in the crowd knows the song already, please do sing along with me.
Thank God you made it. Mumbai local. The first train in India ran from Mumbai to Thane.
That's my hometown.
Nice. And the surprising fact about Mumbai locals, each day 7.5 million people are using it and it's still running efficiently.
Yeah. It's the most efficient public transport system in the world.
Never late. Also,
it is
never late.
Every
6 minutes,
one train.
But the Mumbai, this city has always been subject to a lot of natural disasters and terror attacks. But the spirit of Mumbai never dies. Mumbai does never give up. The city rises up again from the ashes like a phoenix bird. I think this another song, it can explain it a lot.
Somebody please. Traditional Maharashtrian couple on their wedding day. Men in Maharashtra wear kurtas like I have worn and dhoti, and women wear sarees. But unlike the sarees were all over in India, we have our own specialities. We have paithani sarees, which you can see in the middle, and we have navwari sarees, which are a different way of wrapping the saree. But men in Maharashtra are not behind in this race of fashion. Let's see the number of headgears men in Maharashtra wear. And you can take your photo with these headgears on our photo booth outside. After this comes the festivals. Maharashtrians celebrate festivals in a very fun way. like Diwali and Holi, we obviously celebrate that because it is celebrated all over India. But we are going to focus specifically on the festivals of Maharashtra. And the first one should be obviously Ganeshotsav. Ganeshotsav is the biggest festival in Maharashtra. It is celebrated for Lord Ganesha and is celebrated everywhere in cities, in villages. Let's have a look in a video. Showcase the spirit of Ganeshotsav.
Thank you. Angal Murti!
That was a kadak performance! So, let's move to the second festival in Maharashtra, which is known as Gudi Padwa. Gudi Padwa is celebrated for the start of New Year. In India, we follow a different calendar known as Shalivahan Shakam. And our calendar is a lunar calendar, so our dates are based on position of the moon. And interesting fact is, currently the Shalivahan Shaka we have is 1941. So we train the Gregorian calendar. On Gudi Padwa, everywhere in Maharashtra, people do this kind of welcome parades where we showcase the tradition and culture. It is quite similar to carnival we have in Aachen. And the last festival that we are going to see is Dahi Handi. Dahi Handi is celebrated in remembrance of Lord Krishna when he was a little boy. His mom used to hide the pot of yogurt on the top shelf. So he used to climb among his friends to get to that pot. The same we do by forming human pyramids, which can be sometimes up to 9 layers. And let's see a video of that.
Let's move on to the most attractive part of the evening. Food. Just like all over India, even Maharashtra, we have a lot of sweets. The first one is Puran Poli. You can say that it's just sweet naan.
The second one is Shrikhanda, which is a yogurt based sweet, and we are going to have it today.
And the next one over here is Ugadi Jai Modak. It's just coconut filled dumplings.
But this is all sweet. Like, don't you have anything spicy?
We do have a lot of spicy food. In fact, Maharashtra is all over famous for its spicy food. The first one over here is Misal Pav, which we are going to serve you tonight.
And the other one is Bharli Vangi, which is made with brinjal, so eggplants.
But this is all about vegetarian dishes. What about non-veg?
We don't disappoint non-vegetarians. Here we have the iconic chicken kolhapuri.
And the Marwani fish fry. This is also available today on the counter.
And then we move to snacks like pani puri, shirai puri, thalipit, which is similar to pancakes. And then pav bhaji. I hope all of you must have tried it, the pav bhaji.
Yes.
Have you?
Yes.
But are we forgetting something?
I think the most our own favorite, vada pav. And you guys are really lucky that we are going to have vada pav tonight as well.
After food, we are moving towards the last section of the evening, folk dances. Maharashtra has a lot of folk dances, and we'll start with Lavani. Lavani is traditionally a traditional dance, generally woman dance Lavani, and Lavani songs are quite sensual in nature. During Lavani, we use a typical folk music instrument called as dholki. So today we are trying to show you how does it sound, and then we are going to have a stupendous Lavani performance.
How was the performance?
It was. Thanks a lot, guys. Let's move on to the next folk dance of Maharashtra, Koli dance. It is a dance of a fisherman, especially from Mumbai region, and it is also famous for its unique music style. As you can see in the picture, even Barack Obama couldn't resist himself dancing on the song. But he was not the only one. I think we have the strange relationship of US president dancing on Indian songs.
Yeah,
especially Maharashtrian songs. Let's see in the next video.
So Govindal is a devotional dance which is mostly danced in the honor of Indian goddesses. So we will be having a music team performing Govindal dance for you, and then we are going to have a surprise performance.
Come on.
This brings us to the end of the performance and the presentation. Did you like the presentation and performance? Yeah. How was it? This wouldn't have been possible without our supporters, Mr. Hasmukh Bhate and Frau Tamara Urban at International Office of Avede Aachen. Our volunteers have a lot of contribution for the success of the event. They are working since morning. And obviously you guys who came to experience Maharashtra. So, thank you.